Hello everyone, and welcome to America Reads Fun Learning Activities. We are college students who create learning activities for kids. Our fun activities are focused on reading, writing, and math. Thank you for joining us to learn today. My name is Mackenzie, and in today's video, we are going to learn about how to ask questions. More importantly, we are going to learn about what questions we should be asking. Asking questions helps us better understand topics and stories. Up first, we are going to create a spider question buddy to help us know what questions we should be asking. So, let's get to the activity. To make our question buddy, we are going to need two pieces of black paper, scissors, white colored pencils, pink colored pencil or any color you'd like to draw the spider's mouth, and a stapler. First, set everything aside except one piece of paper and one white colored pencil. On your black piece of paper, we are going to draw a question mark. When you get to the bottom, leave the circle at the bottom of the question mark connected so that way it's easier to cut out. It should look something like this. Now, you're going to take your scissors and cut your question mark out. Remember, hold the scissors away from your body and ask an adult for help. Carefully cut out along the lines that we already created. Go ahead and pause the video now to cut out your question mark. Once your question mark is cut out, it should look a little something like this. Now, set your question mark to the side and take your second piece of paper. We are going to use this piece of paper to cut out our spider's legs. Hold your paper horizontally like so, and take your scissors and cut along the edge of the paper. Create very thin and long strips of paper. Remember, hold your scissors away from your body and ask an adult for help. You should have something like this. Once it is cut out, we are going to fold it to create the shape of a spider's legs. You're going to fold up like so, flip your paper over and fold down. Flip your paper over and fold up. Flip your paper over and fold down. Continue this all the way to the bottom of the strip of paper. Once it's complete, it should look something like this. It'll have bends in it to make the spider's leg. This is one leg. Now we are going to create seven more, as spiders have eight legs. Go ahead and pause the video now to create the rest of your spider's leg. Remember, first cut a strip from the edge of your paper, and then fold up and down until you get something like this. Pause the video now to complete the rest of your legs. You should have eight in total once done. Once complete, your spider legs should look something like this. Now, we have to attach them to our spider's body. You're going to take our question mark and focus on this bottom part, the circle, which is our spider's body. So, we are going to place four legs on each side. To attach your spider's legs, you can use tape, glue, or a stapler. I am going to use a stapler, but you can use whatever you have at home. If you're using a stapler, please ask an adult for help. Pause the video now to attach your spider's legs. Once complete, it should look a little something like this. Now, we are going to create our spider's face. Go ahead and draw two big circles in the middle. This is your spider's eyes. Now, let's give them a big smile with your second color, whatever you chose. I used pink. Now, using this pink colored pencil, I am going to write my question prompts. These are the words that help me know what questions I should be asking. First, we are going to write what. Then, we are going to write why. This is spelt W-H Y. Next, we are going to write when. This is W H E N. Now we are going to write where. This is W H E R E. Lastly, we are going to write how, which is spelled H O W. These are the words that are going to help us know what questions we should be asking when we are reading a story or we have questions about a situation or topic. So, now we are going to set our question buddy aside and we are going to read Spiders by ReadWorks. Some spiders are small. Some are as small as the head of a pin. Some spiders are big. One of the biggest spiders is the Goliath bird-eating tarantula. It is bigger than a human hand. Large or small, all spiders have some things in common. They all have 8 legs. They all have fangs. Fangs are long, sharp teeth. Spiders are helpful to people. They eat insects that harm farm crops. They eat insects that carry diseases. Think twice before you squash one. Now that we have read our story, let's set it to the side right here and let's ask the important questions. So what are those questions? Well, let's look at our spider buddy. They remind us to ask first, what? So what is a what question that you have about spiders from the story? I could ask, what are fangs? If we look to the story, we know that fangs are long, sharp teeth. Next, we have to ask why. We could ask maybe, why do spiders have fangs? The story does not tell us this, but we can take a guess. Maybe the spiders use their fangs to eat the insects. So when do spiders eat the insects? Well, probably when they're hungry. Next, we can ask where. So, where do spiders live? Is there any information you know about spiders that may help you answer this question? I think I know. A lot of spiders live in their webs. Lastly, we have to ask how. My question is, how do spiders help humans? Well, the story tells us that they are helpful to us because they eat the insects that harm our crops and that carry diseases. So continue using your question buddy, asking the important questions, what, why, when, where, and how, to learn more about the spiders and the story we read. Thank you for joining us to learn today. We hope you come back and learn some more. Please like and subscribe to our channel, and we will be back with more fun videos.